it's officially on. I'm continuing with my gladiator. And last time I stopped playing, I was at level 2, Doom difficulty, a replay. So here are my stats, as you can see. I'm not too far from level 43. I feel that once I get into level 43, I can definitely start doing some more mushroom farming, get these stats to an ideal level. But as you can see, this is what I'm currently dealing with. All right. Alright, so going over the gear rather quickly, very nice, unique weapon here. I'm just going to highlight everything, and this will probably be exported to YouTube later, so you can just pause and read the stats there. And I suppose anyone who is interested in my gear later, I'll be happy to show them. As long as they ask me in chat. And there's that weapon too. It's not exactly ideal for me to have this weapon, but I'm holding on to it because it's the best crossbow I have so far. And that's it, really. This is actually down to level 4. So there's two bosses here. I'm thinking I'd cut my way through. Oh.
No.
Hey, Relic, how's it going, my friend? I want to check something really quickly. Okay. Oh, yeah. The heat, definitely.
I have no room for this crap.
That's similar to what I've been doing lately. Well, apart from getting back into this mod and playing my old Gladiator, not much of anything else. Just been working, and been coasting at the house.
I have no room for this crap.
Any gains? Oh, right. I've actually lost weight since the last time. I went from, believe it or not, I went from 194 to about 180. And I think it's because of the summer heat. I still eat the same, it's just the heat's been able to burn off some water weight here. Guardian helm, this piece of trash. But I'm still in good shape. I'll be generous and say that I'm 5'10. 5'10, 5'11. And I'm currently at 180.8 pounds. So that's definitely not bad. And I think the ideal way for me to get in shape was for me to lose the excessive weight. So there's that too. Yeah, I say if you're about 6'1", you should be somewhere around 190. The job I do, and the work that I do at Walmart DC, it actually allows me to burn off excessive fat. So I can eat heavily at the end of the day because my body is still at the process of burning off calories. Well, that's pretty impressive.
No.
This crafted mace. Oh, it's all good. Workouts at home is not bad, as long as there is dedication involved and commitment to it.
Hello, my friend.
But of course, I'm just stating the obvious there, so no need for me to do that.
Greetings!
As soon as my stream reaches about 30 minutes, I'm gonna do a small exercise in between. Every 30 minutes. You know, that's funny, because that was something I used to do too, back then. And when it came to either watching WWF or UFC when it was getting popular. I never actually understood what it was, but the UFC made me hungry. Every time I watched UFC, I felt like going straight to the kitchen and just making something to eat, and then I go back and watch more UFC. Oh man. Cannibalize. Really? Well, that's pretty cool. Oh no. All those Diablo accounts gone. I wonder if people thought it would be a good idea. Hindsight, probably not so good idea, because hindsight is always 20/20. Don't cheat, people. It's only gonna get you in trouble. No. All that time for nothing. Unless they did what I think they were planning to do, which is to make copies of all those save files. But even then, accounts were just like, wow. It's safe to say that we're talking about accounts that literally took years in order to be the best accounts out there. That may not necessarily be a solvable case, though. The whole botting thing. I think that kind of thing is going to be everywhere when it comes to online. There's always going to be that someone somewhere who finds a way to bot somehow. Yeah, that's 15 years of legitimacy, so you totally have nothing to worry about. Hey, Mega Man, how you doing, my friend?
No.
Yeah, you can say that. It's I say it's a semi-new setup, but I definitely had to make some furniture rearrangements.
No.
Now I have a room where I just sleep in, and this room is basically where I do the gaming activities. It's still the same room, just the bed has been moved out completely.
Hello, my friend.
Also, had to get a new table. Had to do it, because the old table was really starting to bother me. Harmony. Do I really want this, though? I probably do. Probably save it for an early mage or something like that. thinking I want to hold on to this, so I'll just use the oils on this thing. There we go.
Greetings!
Yeah, this is definitely not the Hell 2. It's the first one. I think I'm going to stick with this one for a while, because the Hell 1 is the very same mod that really got me interested in playing modded versions of Diablo. That, and there's a lot going on with the Hell 2 that I honestly don't like. It kind of rubs me the wrong way. For example, I mean, it's, I suppose it's okay that shared stash is no longer a thing, but at the same time, you have items already that you cannot stash. For example, there's gold you can't stash anymore in the Hell 2. You can't stash, what was it? You can't stash elixirs anymore in the Hell 2. So, in my opinion, the whole concept of getting rid of shared stash is kind of weird. Well, town floor for me is the stash when it comes to playing Diablo 1 single player, but there are not that many individuals who play the Hell 2 that have access to the multiplayer standard, using Hamachi and all that. Yes, definitely. The last thing I wanted to do when playing a game that I've always been coming back to for as long as I remember, is to get triggered. That's the last thing I want to do. And I think that playing the Hell 2 is definitely going to get me triggered. I think Diablo the Hell 2 is going to be the brand new Salt mod. Like, Salt mod 2.0. It's very possible right now. I think the lead developer is insane. Okay, no, we're not doing that. Well, for some Diablo games, if the replay value is there, you're definitely going to enjoy it some more. Sad to say that I will not be encountering King Leora soon. Okay, no, that's not happening, though. It's definitely not happening. I just might die here. Oh, I hate that so much, that partial healing. I hate that partial healing is such a random number. I know I mentioned this somewhere before about partial healing. The number is completely randomized. It's not a guaranteed 50%. It just ranges between crazy numbers sometimes. So it has me in panic mode whenever I'm trying to heal, and partial can go from some crazy number of 1 to 500 at any given moment. It's crazy. Oh, it's almost 30 minutes. Cool. Oh no, come back over here. Got him. Alright, it's officially 30 minutes. Because I don't want to be known for sitting down all day while trying to stream. Oh gosh. When potions suddenly age and they no longer have the same potency. Oh gosh, that would be messed up. That would be so messed up. Yeah, these are Gunner brand. Helps with reduced eye strain. All right, so I'm gonna start something. All right, back to Elmod. There we go. That was 15. Yeah, I like this shirt too, Relic. I think it's a pretty cool shirt. I think I have another one just like it. Probably in my clothing stash somewhere. No idea where to find it. But that exercise is really, really good for triceps. And I couldn't kill the guy. Oh gosh, don't go into level 5 yet. I don't want to go to level 5 yet. No, those mages can't ride a mana. It's unfortunate too. Oh gosh, no. Gotcha. Chopped you in half. I like to believe that anyway. And darn. Useless item. Oh no, you don't. Oh my gosh, stop! Oh no, 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 no. Yeah, it's actually a workout rack. I can do various exercises in there. Mind you, it's all calisthenics related, but still, I can do plenty of exercises in there. Yes, definitely.
I can't carry anymore.
Triceps are so important. A great deal of lifting consists of tricep ability. Oh my gosh, these wolves. Oh my gosh. Yep, that too. Shields are a thing in this mod, but I'm playing a character class that doesn't really rely on shields. It relies on axe wielding, duo wielding, and crossbow use, strength line. The alt tab key for a combination. Where is the boss? I just want this to get over with now. Because I can't even save the game until either my character dies, which, in my opinion, I really want to make that as unlikely as possible, or I kill the boss, which is right here. Alright then.
I have no room for this crap.
We got him, boys. We got him. But I still can't save the game because there's another monster that spotted me, apparently. Oh gosh, no. Nope, not today. Not today. I am not dealing with that mess today. Like I said, I am not dealing with that mess today. Oh, no, you don't.
Not enough mana.
We're still not finished yet. Yeah, the thing about shield block, I mean, the shield switch strategy is that I need a shield that actually has good fast, that actually has fast block. I don't know any that are at a very decent level that are going to fit my gladiator very well. Yes, corner strats for the win, definitely. Always enjoyed corner strats. It's not released today. It's going to be released on the 26th. At least that's what the notices keep. At least that's what the notice reads on Discord. It might have been a pushback. I'm not too sure about that. Looks like I'm playing the game called Wait Until Fury Wears Off so I can cast Town Portal Spell. Because that is the downside of using Fury. Your spells are unusable as a gladiator under the influence of Fury. Let's get these ID'd.
Hello, my friend.
Hey, let me check and see. I think I like that one, actually. Not too bad, I guess. Not too bad. This is good for a Paladin later. I may actually play Paladin again. And Emerald Ring.
Stay for a moment. I have a story you might find interesting. A caravan that was bound for the Eastern Kingdoms passed through here some time ago. It was supposedly carrying a piece of the heavens that had fallen to Earth. The caravan was ambushed by cloaked riders just north of here along the roadway. I searched the wreckage for this sky rock, but it was nowhere to be found. If you should find it, I believe that I can fashion something useful from it.
Yeah, the whole thing about Hammerdin and Diablo 1, I don't know if that's possible. I would like for it to be possible, but it's unlikely in this mod. Maybe in the Hell 2. Maybe. And that's a really strong maybe. Only if Mordor is interested in that concept, Hammerdin.
Greetings!
But I would dare say, to answer your question, you have to get rid of... The only reason why it seems that way, Mega Man, when it comes to not being able to save until all monsters are clear, is because that's how unique monster presence is. They can spot you from just about any known location on that particular map, as long as you haven't beaten them yet. And that's only if... That's only if they spotted you upon walking up to it. As soon as you walk in that location, that can trigger chain aggro, which pretty much is you trigger one mob, and there's a chance that a mob right next to it gets triggered as well, and they all just like to pile up on you. Yeah, I hate the spam as well, but it's the only attack they have, so I can't really complain too much about it. Unlike, I would dare say, advocates or... What else are there? there are the teleporting mages that can either shoot fireball or charge bolt, and they can teleport when you get really close to them. Not fooling me, I wasn't born yesterday. Nope. Not today. Not today. Alright, I got 12 more minutes until the next exercise. Here I am, trying to clear everything. But the major difference between Paladin and Gladiator in this one is that Gladiators are just very much tanky. They can be insanely tanky in the late game. Paladins, although they may not be able to measure up in the same amount of health and toughness as a gladiator without shields, they can make up with that for shields. Oh crap. I might die here, actually. Unique monster spotted. Yeah, that's always a nice feature the Hell 2 allows you to have. And I'm at level 43. Nice. Also, Axe weapon damage is actually based on the bonus damage, is based on the amount of vitality I have, so that's always pretty cool. Zigzag, 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 zigzag. Keep moving, keep moving, keep moving, keep moving. I'm good, I'm good. I swear I'm good. Alright. Yes, yeah, 7 more levels to level 50. I'm looking forward to that too. Oh, oh, those level ups are gonna be a big nightmare though. Another tricky thing about this mod, as well as the original Diablo, you cannot max out your stats with skill points alone. You gotta find elixirs and stuff. It's all the more reason why. I'm looking forward to doing some elixir farming later. Well, at level 50, you can just say that you have your character at level 50. You get bragging rights, I guess. But that is the level cap for the game. I'm pretty sure you're aware, so it's kind of like me stating the obvious again. Useless piece of junk. Stop it. One more to go. Come on. Okay, sure. That might have been a cheap way of winning, but I don't care. I'm gonna cheese however I find a way to. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna cheese however I can find. It's gonna be... Especially when you have monsters that can just slow down my health like that. I also hate scenarios when there's a melee monster that's heading towards me, and I have to deal with him. And at the same time, there are enemies who can attack me from a range, getting free shots on me. I hate that. So, cheese however you can. Find a way to level the playing field. Well, the thing about levels in this game is that there's a stat cap for each level. So you can't have high stats such as 200 or higher, let's say if you're at level 1. There was a time when I was playing the same character. It was a while back, and I noticed that my stats got capped when I was at level 41, which was really strange. It was probably at level 40 or 41, somewhere around the two. Just right now, I'm making sure that the monsters are cleared. I think cheesing is what makes this mod even more fun to play. Yes, exactly. Don't cheat, just cheese it. There are people out there who don't know the difference. We have to remind them. We have to help them find... We have to help them so they will know the difference. Seppy, how's it going, my friend? I hope all is going well. Get rid of the helm, quick. Taking that crucible sounds like a 9-to-5 that you just really don't want to go to. I'm just kidding. I have no idea what crucible is. But I do believe that dungeon level 4 is almost cleared. There's one small area I have yet to explore. That is the last monster. A double workout break? Well, I'm having a small workout break every 30 minutes, so It's not too bad. Great conflict.
Take heed and bear witness to the truths that lie herein, for they are the last legacy of the Haradrim. There is a war that rages on even now, beyond the fields that we know, between the utopian kingdoms of the high heavens and the chaotic pits of the burning hells. This war is known as the Great Conflict, and it has raged and burned longer than any of the stars in the sky. Neither side ever gains sway for long, as the forces of light and darkness constantly vie for control over all creation.
Oh man, I haven't done push-ups like that in a long time.
I've never been here before.
I'm pretty sure I can do 50, but... they'll have to be explosive push-ups. That means the moment that I start, it has to be with the intent of... That means the moment that I start doing the push-ups, it has to be with the intent of explosivity.
This must be what Griswold wanted. Not enough mana.
And I can't. Oh gosh. Wait, it hasn't reached the second half hour yet. Darn. There we go, finally.
I have no room for this crap.
Yeah, they're definitely hidden boys for sure. I'm gonna go back to the face cam. It's officially been an hour since I started streaming. So, let's go back to the face cam, shall we? If I can actually click on this thing. Wait, there we go. I may not reach 50, but we will find out together if I can. I'll try to get somewhere close to it. I'm gonna use the rack again. Consider it to be close grip here. Fine. If I can just get this whole thing to start working properly, much appreciated. Alright. 3. Well, looks like I'm gonna have to settle with 40. And there is someone at the door, so I'm gonna have to check on that real quick. Oh, okay, so the door was taken care of. I at least managed to do 40 in one setting, so that's good.
Hello, my friend.
Actually keep that.
Let me see that. Aye, it is as I believed. Give me a moment. Here you are. I arranged pieces of the stone within a silver ring that my father left me. I hope it serves you well. Greetings. Hello, my friend.
Yeah, I'd say so. I can definitely feel that within certain parts of the chest and the biceps, definitely.
Greetings!
I don't want to keep that. Well, back when I first bought it,
greetings.
I'd say it was about 100. And I had that for years. I'll tell you right now, I probably wouldn't buy a rack if it cost $350. Oh my gosh! No! That happened. Just goes to show you, even with max fire resistance, well, even with 85% fire resist, I still got myself in trouble. I was like, oh my gosh, I can't believe I actually got in trouble. And so, wait. Yep, we're bringing back the trap chest again. I'm pretty sure there's someone who wants to clip that later. And so, left beyond the Gateway of Blood and past the Hall of Fire, Valor waits for the Hero of Light to awaken.
And so, locked beyond the Gateway of Blood and past the Hall of Fire, Valor awaits for the Hero of Light to awaken.
Thank you. Those arrows that used to do so much damage to me back in hardware difficulty. I hated that so much. Yes. Yes, they did. Oh my gosh. I knew it was a trap chest because the helm, was it a helm I'm wearing? No, it's the collar. The collar gives me enhanced perception. So I already knew it beforehand, it was a trap chest. I just thought there was gonna be some gold in there. Was I mistaken? It's like, no, the trap chest again. Oh my gosh. I thought that door was gonna get open. Oh yeah, it was open. Oh, just move. For all we know, they probably would have a game like that in Japan. You know what happens when we Americanize game shows? Oh gosh, no. Ooh, if it wasn't for the resist I have. It's a chain aggro. Please, do not make me the host. Don't make me the host of it. But this is definitely a chain aggro situation. I'm dealing with, what are they called? I think they're called Unseen and Lich here. No, Shadow. Okay, so, dealing with Shadow and Lich. Floor-wise, I'm at level 5. Yes, I do, actually. It's this Gazing Call of the Stars. It gives me enhanced perception. Well, it goes about as low as floor 24 in this mod. Actually, in the original Hellfire, there were no connections between floors 16 through 24. There was just the Hive and the Crypt, but the creator of the mod, Mordor, renamed it to Abyss, the Hive level, and he eventually got around to connecting all the dungeon floors. I hate those guys. They use projectiles when they're far away and then they flash you to death when you get really close to them. And he likes to teleport. Oh no, you don't. No, you don't. Get to this corner. That's what you get for walking up on me. Yeah, they definitely are. No question. Which is why I was relying heavily on my minus DFE and my all res here. Constricting Ring helps with that, but at the same time, that's minus 7 total attributes and minus hit points and losing all regeneration. So the only two beneficial attributes, Matt, the only two real benefits there are just the minus 10 DFE and resist all being maxed out. But surprisingly enough, I only had to rely on my healing for a good bit and not too many potions. So that's always good. Yeah, they want me to, but nothing's gonna really replace this helmet for a while. Just a really good helmet altogether.
Hello, my friend.
So there's, yep, this helm, I'm throwing that away, getting rid of that. Well, I might keep this, I don't know.
Greetings!
Yeah, that's a really good find for a helmet. Something I've been looking forward to. I also like the fact that there's zero malice on there. Everything is just positive. Plus 5 to all attributes, plus 28 to hit points, plus 60 to armor, and minus 21 DFE. Combat staff. Okay. I think I was on the mist of... What was I doing, actually? Alright, so I used that already. The blood fountain. No, pedestal of blood. Blood fountain is when I click on it and it replenishes my health. I don't know what I'm going on about. Oh gosh. It's chain aggro? Nothing good in terms of weapon.
No.
I think you remember when I lost it after finding finding a really good weapon called Aghanar's Dirge. I don't know why I hit the tab key there.
Hello, my friend.
Let me check the chance to hit on this thing. Yeah, I suppose that's not too bad, but
greetings.
It lacks in everything else I need for it. So I'm just gonna sell that, make some extra gold, repair my gear, go back in. And there are about six of these bad guys. I like this one a lot more than that one. I get faster hit recovery from Cyclone, and minus 24 DFV in comparison to minus 17. Not to mention with minus 10 all attributes, it just really wears me down. Yeah, definitely, especially if I'm running low on mana potions, which hasn't seemed to be a problem. Has not yet seemed to be a problem for my Gladiator. Uh-oh, spammers again. Messing around. There we go, exit down to level 6, but we're not ready for that yet.
No!
Oh, you don't say. Well, I would be so bold as to add that one and this right here. More points to dexterity. Okay, let's do this whole thing with stuff.
Hello, my friend. Greetings.
Oh, good night. So that is the exit of the town. Trap chest. I'm really curious as to find out what's in there, though. Okay. That's what it was. Wait, what was that? A room full of gold and some monsters. Oh, why? Come on. Alright then, we're good. Oh gosh, please.
Hello, my friend. Stay a while and listen.
Yaroslav, 64, thank you so much for being a follower. I very much appreciate it. I'd like to welcome you aboard the team. I'd like to welcome you to the association. Hope you enjoy your stay. Necessarily be a chain apple here, but I hate that so much. I was so close to killing him, but I didn't want to risk it. Well, if anything, gladiators can do splash damage with the axe. Okay, we got him. What? Don't tell me. I have to do that all over again. I didn't even mean to click on that. Oh my gosh. I turned over to read the message on the screen, and then out of nowhere, my character goes up to the chest and it's all she wrote. Oh my gosh. That's not your fault. If anything, it's my fault because I messed up. The bright side is that I get a do-over, so. Nah, It's already been set in stone, the RNG, so... And I think that's due to the fact that there is an actual save load mechanic in single player. Unlike multiplayer, where your progress is saved automatically for your character. Alright, I don't know why Dreadlust hit me so hard, but yeah, he's got a good put down. Alright. Yeah, it's the same full helm. I thought so. But the cool thing is, you notice how his health was suddenly at half when I was focusing on him? That's what I was talking about in terms of the splash damage there. With the axe. So, that actually works either way, with or without Fury. And, okay, another helm. But this actually has high requirements on it. I don't know if I'm gonna wear it anyway. Holy water for my trouble. Thank you. Thank you. So, I am getting pretty close to level 6 at the moment. Dungeon level wise. And I'm gonna head to town. Alright, let's do this thing. Alright, go identify items.
Hello, my friend!
See, a helm of vitality is not something I'm looking forward to when I get to a really high level, so the answer is no. But I do like this helm, though. It's pretty nice. This is actually pretty nice in comparison to that.
Greetings!
You know something's up when a mid-tier helm is a lot better than a high-tier. I'm about 1 hour 37 minutes in, and yep, back to the face cam. So, I have to finish the other 10. Man. Gosh, can I not do this right? To focus on. I really wish it stopped doing that. Just stay. Oh my gosh. So I finished the 10, and so I finish with the last 10, and then I do something else. No, it wasn't. Alright, let me go ahead and start. Alright, so that 10 was over. Done with. That actually concludes the 50, right? That concludes the 50. But there's something else I'm looking to do. Another random exercise, if you will. Or was it right here? No, that wasn't it. Definitely wasn't it. Right there. Right there. I think that's it. Right. Somewhere around here. The camera was pointing down slightly. So this is actually 35-pound kettlebell here. Not too heavy. Well, to do somewhere between a certain amount of reps I feel comfortable doing. So all right. I believe that was 50. I could be wrong.
Hello, my friend. Stay a while and listen.
Hello, good friend.
Ah, Galundra. Thank you so much for becoming a follower of the stream. I'd like to welcome you to the association. I certainly hope you enjoy your stay. Well, in the beginning I was, well, not necessarily in the beginning, but before the Hell 2 came into the picture, I was playing the Hell 1 for quite a while. I always liked how it stuck to the original roots to bring back that nostalgic value. And yet, at the same time, it just feels a lot more old-fashioned in comparison to the Hell 2. The Hell 2 in the beginning was looking pretty good, but I think now there's this crazy system that's going on with it. The thing is, when I was first starting to play Diablo, Hell 2, honestly didn't mind playing it. It was looking pretty good. I understand that when it came to... Exactly. There are too many bad things. For one, is getting rid of the shared stash. I get the idea that you don't want certain items to be duplicated, which is totally fine, but that process was eliminated already when you made it to where elixirs and gold couldn't be stashed. That process was already eliminated. So my question is, why would you make it to where there's no longer a shared stash when you've already eliminated the process of duplicating items? Because you can't stash those same items. It's not like you can create, it's not like you can copy and paste save files over and over again, because that was eliminated too. There was that, and the crossbow potential. That's cool. Yeah, that whole thing, what was it? You're not being able to change your armor? That's what that was all about, right? You're not being able to change your armor when you're in battle. I think the Hell 2, in my opinion, I think it favors a whole lot more of Iron Man than any other mode. Oh, right. That's really bad. You're not being able to change armor in Iron Man mode. Opinion, that kind of defeats the purpose of Iron Man, because with Iron Man you're only able to work with what you have. That includes items that you have currently equipped and others that are in your personal inventory. So if you can't use those at any given time, all the while you're not able to go back to town, then yeah, Iron Man is killed. Are those minions? Another opinion I have when it comes to making drastic changes like that, when it comes to the mod that you're looking forward to having people play, is you personally gotta do testing yourself. That's how I see it. You gotta be able to commit to a live stream test just to.
I have no room for this crap.
This way you can carefully elaborate to everyone how things are supposed to work, which honestly I have not seen done.
No.
Oh gosh. It's a chain aggro. So let me be right back. Okay, there we go. That one thing always bothers me. When sudden changes are made, potential eye strain here. I kind of figured that, honestly. I really did. The moment when he got rid of the huge damage dealing, when it came to crossbows and triple shot, getting rid of that. Getting rid of multi-shot when under fury was a serious cripple.
I can't carry anymore.
Because I feel that there should be some kind of late game reward.
No.
After all the time you put into the game, you find yourself a very nice crossbow that I might be so bold becomes a game changer. You're looking forward to that game changer to stay with you for as long as it possibly can. That's
hello,
hilarious.
My friend. Greetings.
One thing I will say in that regard is that there are people in the world who like things the way they like them. And as long as you're a part of their domain, they're going to change however they see fit, even if they don't show you proof of how to endure such changes. There's also the mentality of where someone can come along and say, if you don't like these changes, then you simply don't have to play. Which is totally fine. And I've proven to myself that I don't like the changes in the game, so I honestly don't play it, let alone stream. The hell too. In order for me to start playing the hell 2 again, there's gonna have to be some crazy change for the greater good that just makes the game a whole lot better. Yeah, that's definitely true. It's like conducting a business. If you look forward to having individuals, right, if you're looking forward to having consumers support your business, then there has to be some kind of, stalemate, some kind of negotiating tactic that works for both parties, creator and consumer. Well, right now I'm focusing on the Hell mod, but there was a time where I was playing Beelzebub. That too. I really hate it when there's... I really, really hate this in games. When there's this concept of nerfing just to nerf, or changing just for the sake of change. We get it. Change is a concept. But at the same time, consider those who actually play your game and want to support you. Yeah, I picked up on that. It is broken. It was another reason why I stopped playing it. Moon Clan. Oh goodness. I think that's a really good question. I suppose the meaning of broken is where there's so much that can be done with the mod itself that hasn't been done yet. Adding more difficulty to the game is good, but at the same time, there has to be... a level playing field when it comes to each of the classes. I personally don't mind the difficulty of Beelzebub. And there are moments where I have played Beelzebub, and for some strange reason, my character just starts acting funny. Like, there would be a soft lock for my character. So that definitely has to get fixed then. I personally have not played Crucible.
Hello, my friend.
Yeah, truth be told, I would much rather have my sanity. I would much rather keep my sanity when it comes to playing, or when it comes to even attempting to play games like that. Normally I would just be like, hey, okay, this game is not for me. I'm just gonna step over here, uninstall, get rid of the whole thing. I like to keep my sanity. I'm already 31. I definitely don't need to lose my sanity at this point in my life. And nowadays, how things are going. Oh my goodness. Oh gosh. No. No. The charge bolt spam. I hate that. Okay. Okay. Yeah, exactly. I like to enjoy games I play too. Oh my gosh, no! No! I gotta empty my inventory. Let me go back to town first. Oh gosh.
Hello, my friend.
That's how it is nowadays.
Greetings.
The older you get, the more you want to enjoy games. You don't want to deal with that whole challenging mentality again. It was okay when we were in our teens and 20s, but not so much anymore. We like the things to be a little easier now, in terms of gaming. We can deal with all the hard stuff when it comes to working actual jobs.
How may I serve you?
Not do that. It is. I mean, there's a stash in this game, but I just have this habit of leaving all my items on the ground. Just because it's a single-player game. That's just one of the things I do. I really can't help it. It's a habit. I'm not gonna lie, there were moments where I was really devoted to a certain game, but as I got older, I was drifting away from devotion to just simply casually playing. So I know exactly what that's like. Well, how much is this? Oh, so that's about 20k gold. Nice. And that leads up to a total of 98,303. And blacksmith oil, of course. Oh, gosh. I'm almost through. No, not almost through. Halfway through level 6. See, is it down there? Chamber of Bone. Gosh, stop it. Okay, that was good. He was barely able to touch me. Thought it was chain aggro for a minute.
I can't carry anymore.
Oh gosh. There we go. Much better.
No.
Well, I couldn't save in that moment because it was, I thought it was a chain aggro, but I realized that there was a monster that was just around the corner that prevented me from saving.
No.
And I think I just used two identify relics there. I could be wrong.
Hello, my friend. Greetings.
Right.
Good day. How may I serve you?
Let me stash away some of this stuff.
Good day. How may I serve you?
I have no room for this crap.
Good day. How may I serve you?
No! No!
Good day! How may I serve you?
Almost done. That's not taking too long to clean. I hope not.
No!
Good day! How may I serve you?
Yeah, that's actually a pretty good one.
Good day. How may I serve you?
That's all right. So next time I get blacksmith oils, then I will certainly use them I'll certainly use them on the deflector. I think I use more than enough on the Balthavir's Decapitator. Chain aggro? And for all I know, it probably is a chain aggro. Oh, don't touch me, don't touch me. Oh my gosh, this stuff is unreal. Yeah, monster density can get really crazy. the ability to change armor in battle is, wow, that's... Man, I remember you telling me that, but I still think it's a silly idea. Silly in the worst way possible, kind of silly. I wonder what the situation was. I'm guessing he might have been in a quest area where monsters are only in certain locations. Instead of being completely randomized like normal dungeon levels. Or, I don't know. It might have been something different. Etherealize. And Golem. Two. What was it actually? Etherealize I can use. Golem I can't use. Alright, take care of yourself, Yaroslav. I really appreciate your. I really appreciate you stopping by. I'm still at a base of 200, aren't I? Yeah, I'm at 200 still. Yep. Alright then. Alright, got an increase in strength by 1 point, that's good.
Beyond the Hall of Heroes lies the Chamber of Bone. Eternal death awaits any who would seek to steal the treasures secured within this room. So speaks the Lord of Terror, and so it is written.
Stop it, guys.
No.
All right, we're good. Ghost Shrine. What do we have for Ghost Shrine, huh? Of course. It's not really a beneficial shrine for my gladiator.
I have no room for this crap.
I don't even think there was anything funny about what just happened there. And I do feel that it's necessary for me to continue just to see how far I can go down in Doom difficulty. And if it doesn't work well, I can always go back to Purgatory and start doing elixir farming again. But, yeah. But it's something that I'm considering doing only because I am presently at level 43.
Friend.
Yeah, I suppose being in the sky is alright.
Greetings!
I got rid of it anyway, though.
Greetings!
Have the book in there, don't I? Yeah, I do. Level 8. That's cool. I'm liking how these maps are generated now. Oh, okay, that's not happening. Nope. That didn't happen. I didn't see it. I think quests in this game are the bane for anyone's sanity. And I say this because unless you know for a fact that you have the gear required for you to complete certain quests, it is highly recommended that you don't even attempt to do it. Which was similar as to why I just glossed over Chamber of Bone as if I didn't care. Oh gosh, get off! See, I was under the impression, some might have been under the impression that I just don't care about Chamber of Bone, but that is not the case. In fact, I've learned the hard way that I was so under-leveled for it. Oh gosh, stop it. Here we go. Oh no, you don't. Get back over here. Man, they like to spam that fireball. Get away. That works. We're good. Alright then. I've gotten pretty far plenty of times, but as far as this gladiator goes, I'm currently at the second run through of Doom difficulty up to, oh my gosh. The first time I went through Doom difficulty, I went as far as dungeon level 8 at the time, and then I made a new game, and the second time I was able to go through, I made it all the way to the Unholy Altar. I had to stop there because I hit another wall, metaphorically, and this is my third run through. So each time I make a new game and start at the same difficulty, I'm getting further. I'm just hoping that I have the means of beating Unholy Altar this time on Doom difficulty. Oh, I'm dead! I thought I was dead. I legit thought I was dead. But if you wish to see my character stats and gear, then feel free to let me know. Gosh, stop it. Gotcha. There's another minion down here. I want to take care of him first. Oh, gosh. Oh! Don't you dare. Uh-huh. Now I know what you're trying to do. You're trying to sleep so you can regenerate all that health back. Oh my gosh. There it is, too. Back here. Trap him against the wall. Corner. There we go. I hate when they do that.
I have no room for this crap.
How am I looking? Not too bad, not too bad. But, right then. Another war staff for my trouble. Game, level with me here. I'm looking forward to getting some gear for my gladiator. Some even better gear. Oh gosh. Took care of you. Purifying spring. Purifying spring, if I recall correctly, is 4 mana. So, I can definitely click on that for mana. There's an axe that gives me fastest attack. I just have yet to get it. Thank goodness for the whole no trap thing so far. No traps really hitting me hard. But there was a trap that one-shotted me earlier today when I was playing. You are. Don't you try to run, don't you do it. I will find you, and I will kill you. Oh my gosh. So I like to say that I am... I want to say 75... No, I'll be... Be more lenient, say 70. 70% complete with level 7. There's probably like a golem around here somewhere. Gargoyle. There they are. No. There we go, we got him. And there are more monsters up there. Nice. Familiars are up there too. Hardening. Reflector. Yep, there you go. Flawless victory. Say. I'll keep those right there for now. Anything else up here? I might as well just go to town. Huh. What's going on?
Hello, my friend.
Oh, Chamber Bone. Not interested. Nope.
Greetings!
Oh, right.
Greetings!
Prepare gear, Baron. Do it. Hesitated. Oh, no. No, that's a chain arrow. Mm-hmm. Bad Sim Path Master. This crap. Definitely didn't stand a chance against me. Oh, no, no. Did I save? Tell me I saved. Yes, I did. No, I didn't save. Oh, gosh, I did not save. I didn't want to waste a potion, though. I shall return. There are a few things I gotta take care of right away. I'll be right back. apologize if that was a long wait for any and all who are watching this stream. But here I am, and we are continuing.
I have no room for this crap.
He's gonna recover his health soon. Someone just fled. Shadow just fled the scene. Now they're ganging up on me. Got a battle plate here. Check that out later. I'll check it out right now. Good old battle plate, huh?
Hello, my friend.
All right.
Greetings. Greetings.
I have no room for this crap.
What? Oh wow, that's just terrible on my part. Terrible. And they're doing that right now.
Not enough mana.
gosh, can I save? Alright. I don't know why I said can I save. I know full well I can't save in the middle of this battle. How much would that sell for?
Greetings!
That's Fire Blast, but it costs 95 magic. Fountain of Tears, no thanks. I think we're going somewhere.
my friend.
Spellcraft, huh?
Greetings!
I think I'm gonna want to hold on to these. Except for that. Book of Charge Bolt, a lousy Griffin Shield. How much of anything else? Alright, I think I'm going to call it here for the time being. For those who stuck around to watch, I really do enjoy your time. For those who have recently followed, thank you so much. It has been so much appreciated. And that's it for me. And what else is there? Maybe I'll see you all next time I stream. Take care of yourselves out there. Be safe.